This project was one that Gavin Wright and I developed when the malaria program at the Sanger Institute first got started. And it's really a melding of two technologies. Gavin's a VEXIS system that allows us to detect protein interactions at a level which we previously have not been able to. And my own lab's interest specifically in erythrocyte invasion and how parasites get inside red blood cells.
Most people, in terms of the treatment of the disease, have focused on the blood stages of the infection because the blood stage of the parasite is actually exposed, albeit very briefly, to the immune system of the host.
All of the symptoms associated with malaria are caused by the erythrocytic part of the life cycle when the parasite is going to invade the human red blood cells. And it is this stage of the life cycle that we decided to target when we began the project. So what I did was to compile a list of proteins that are displayed at the surface of the human red blood cells and a list of proteins that are displayed at the surface of the parasite.
For me, the critical breakthrough that was necessary for this research to happen was our ability to actually express the plasmodium proteins. So before we started this experiment, we had a lot of advice from our colleagues, and many of them were saying that, look, this is going to be essentially impossible. Technically, to produce these parasite proteins is very, very difficult. And so we had a great deal of concern that when we started to do this experiment that we simply wouldn't be able to do it, that we wouldn't be able to express those proteins. But happily, we were.
The reason there's so few protein-protein interactions known between the malaria and the red blood cell is because these protein-protein interactions are very weak and transient, so they happen very, very quickly, and it's very difficult to detect them in the laboratory. So we've developed a method called AVEXIS, which has been designed specifically to detect low-affinity interactions, and what it does is that it pentamerizes one of the proteins, which means you have five copies of the proteins bunched together to increase the half-life of the interaction, so they stick together for a bit longer, and then if it binds, you see a clear color change, which is really nice, so you can just see it by eye. It goes from yellow to red.
There were not a very large number of protein interactions that we identified, but amongst the ones that we detected was one involving a parasite protein called RH5. And that was particularly interesting because we knew from other researchers that the parasite absolutely needed RH5 to survive.
So my role in this project was to validate the interaction once it was found through the AVEXIS screen, and we did this using biochemistry and biophysical analysis. So basically we showed that the two proteins interact directly using the BioCore, and that the interaction was a very weak interaction, which is to be expected.
After identifying this interaction, Julian Rayner's lab did all of the functional validation. And I was actually coming out of the office space just on the other side when I met Leyla, who had been doing all of these invasion assays. And she told me, look, if we block the interaction, we block the invasion completely. And that was a tremendous surprise and a tremendous excitement too.
Well, we saw blocking of invasion, complete blocking of invasion, and it was a complete surprise. It wasn't that we were expected. So at the beginning it's a little bit of you can't believe it. But then when you realize that you are observing for the first time a receptor that is essential for invasion, the feeling is complete excitement, and you just want to share it with everybody that you know that you have something really big in your hands.
The next steps for this research is to try and move beyond what is a fascinating biological finding with great hope for translation into a vaccine, into actually developing such a vaccine. So Gavin and I, in collaboration with other scientists at Oxford University, are now taking those steps, trying to move towards vaccine trials and see whether we can turn this into a treatment that could actually save lives.